Oh, it's sunny today, isn't it?
Hey guys, welcome to the start of a new weekly vlog. Today is Wednesday. Wednesday, I'm leaving the house. I'm going to Central London. I'm going to get Botox. Don't judge me. I had Botox for the first time last year. It was actually this time last year. There must be something in the air or the weather every October, November that makes me want to get Botox. Yeah, I had it done last year for the first time at the age of 35, and it really didn't last long on me. I want to say it lasted 2 months. Like, it didn't even last up until Christmas. I think that might be because it was my first time, so maybe they didn't put too much in. Or maybe it's because I've got a very expressionate forehead. Is that the word? Expressional. My forehead moves a lot, basically, so I think maybe that, because I move it so much, maybe it just wore off quicker. I am going today to see Dr. Ahmed, who is the aesthetics doctor on Instagram. He's got like a million followers on Instagram, which is amazing. Like, that just proves how incredible he is. He's been doing my microneedling this year for my acne. But today we're doing Botox and I'm so excited. I think I'm gonna be having it here. Obviously, I'm not going to judge anyone for the work that they get done. For me personally, I can never see myself getting fillers. Like, that's just not something that I think I'm ever going to do. But Botox, occasionally, like, it's not going to be a really frequent thing, but every now and again, once a year perhaps, I will get it done. Maybe in my forehead. Because I've just been looking at pictures of myself recently, and I'm just not happy with my lines. I know it's really annoying because I always said, like, even, honestly guys, even when I was a teenager, me and my friends would talk about Botox. It wasn't as big then as it was now, but me and my friends would talk about it, and I would always be the one being like, no, I want to grow old gracefully. I want to embrace my natural skin. And then, you know, things change. You get older and people are, what's the word where you're like two things at once? Will Google know if I type that in? What's the word when you're two things at once? No, it's not concurrently. What's the word where you can like two different things? No. What is the word I'm thinking of? Hypocritical? What's that word where you're like two things at once? Like, people are like, can have one thing, but then they do another, and it's like they're not like a perfect person. What word is that? Anyway, I'll let you know what word I'm thinking of in a minute. But yeah, things change. I'm getting Botox. I'm gonna do another video, I think, about my Botox kicking in, because that did so well online last time. And yeah, also, we just got to address the elephant in the room. The elephant being, I ate like so much ice cream last week. I ate about 5 portions of ice cream last week, and normally I don't eat ice cream much because it gives me cystic acne, very different to the normal hormonal acne I get. The hormonal acne I get is normally just around my chin, and they're like whiteheads that come and go quite quickly. Ice cream gives me like under the skin cystic painful acne, and that's what's going on with my skin at the moment. I actually don't think you're supposed to wear makeup to a Botox appointment, but I am, because I'm so self-conscious of my skin today. So first spot being here, cystic. Second one being here, cystic painful ice cream spot. This is why I don't eat ice cream. So let's just ignore that. I'm like not touching it. I'm putting like spot patches on it to try and bring it down, but yeah, my skin's not great, so let's ignore that. But I will take you along to my appointment with me. I am in Bond Street. I'm a little bit early, so I picked up a white chocolate matcha from Bank Street, which is actually really good, really delicious. And I'm just walking to my appointment now. Just a quick check how my forehead is doing. Oh, I should also say, I've taken some paracetamol about half an hour before my appointment, just so it doesn't hurt as bad. I am also, it's like that time of the month, so I know everything's a little bit more painful around this time. Wait, are you here now?
Hey, I am here
with my favorite.
Hi guys, I didn't realize you were recording.
Oh, sorry. It's very quick, isn't it? So, Botox today.
Yes.
So, Dr. Ahmed, obviously, I said this earlier, but he did my microneedling earlier in this year, and my skin has been so nice since then. I was going to say, I've been eating a lot of ice cream recently, so I've got some, like, cystic spots.
Okay.
Just ignore them. Don't judge me.
I saw nothing. It's fine.
Okay, good. So, yeah, Botox, and I'm just so excited because, as you can see, I've got a very expressionful forehead.
I mean, you're very expressive, aren't you? But I think there's nothing wrong with that, and Botox is not something that we ever push at anyone.
No.
So if you ever feel like, the little fine lines and wrinkles bother you, it's a great option, and actually we can customize the dose to make it either full Botox or baby Botox, for example.
So it's
and
not as noticeable that you're
it's
having
not
it.
Like in the movies when they're like, she's not moving at all. It's very like,
I feel like
subtle.
A lot of people get scared, don't they, about it being or looking too fake or looking like you've had work done. So that's a great option.
I think this is why people come to me as a GP. We're really able to customize the doses to make it very bespoke, essentially, for the patient that I have there.
You guys, if you're going to get Botox anywhere, you have to come to Ahmed. He's literally, you've always made me feel so, like, at ease and comfortable. And I think when you're going, especially if you're going for your first treatment,
It's so personal, so invasive sometimes. You want to be comfortable in the environment.
You want to, like, trust the person that you're leaving your face in their hands. So.
Absolutely, and this is why I always say, do as much research as you feel comfortable with.
Yeah.
Look them up. I mean, please only go to medical professionals, but you can look them up on the GMC website, for example, which is for doctors, the GDC for dentists, the NMC for nurses. You can see everything we've done, any kind of restrictions on someone's license, any complications, any kind of bit more information.
People don't know this
stuff. Because actually saying doctor doesn't mean that they have a license. Maybe they've been removed from the register. Mm. Maybe they've had investigations. Maybe there are other things going on.
Mm-hmm.
So please feel comfortable and empowered enough to do your homework and do your research.
Yeah. So I'm going to leave your links down below in the description box. And if any of you are considering it, also not just London, Leeds.
And Cheshire. You forgot that.
Yeah.
You were like, Leeds.
I don't think I've ever been to Cheshire before.
Come visit. We're in Wilmslow. Come say hi.
So yeah, I'll leave the details down below and you can check them out. And then, look, let's get rid of this.
Let's do it.
I am home, Maurice.
Are you a good boy?
Feeling a bit needy? Look at that little face. The cutest. I'm home. I'm feeling great. Last time I had a headache after I had Botox. At the moment, I'm feeling okay. Oh my god, I love you so much. So we did Botox between my eyebrows and on my forehead. You're not going to be able to see it at all. We were going to do some around the eyes, but actually I kind of said didn't really want that. I don't think I really need it. I quite like my little lines. I think they're kind of cute there, but definitely needed to sort this frown line out, which is so deep. So yeah, it feels a bit weird when I do that, just a bit sore. But the needle that Dr. Ahmed uses is so thin. It's like, he said it's thinner than a strand of hair and like you could hardly see it. So it wasn't painful at all. Helped by also the paracetamol I took beforehand. We've just had two very exciting deliveries. G's parents said that they were sending us dinner for this evening and we've been trying to work out for all week what they've sent, and it's just arrived and it's from the Magpie Cafe in Whitby, which if you don't know about, it's like the most amazing fish and chips seafood restaurant in Whitby. I didn't know that they did home delivery, and this box smells so fishy. So I'm going to open it now and get it in the fridge. Exciting. I wonder what we're eating tonight. I wonder if it's like fish and chips that we just have to heat up, or we're going to have to like pan fry some fish. I have no idea. Stop. Oh my god. We've got lobster. We've got two lobsters. This must have cost them so much. Dressed and ready to eat. And then we've got some crab pate. I'm going to have to get G to get some chips on the way home. We can have lobster and chips for dinner. How fancy is that? Oh my goodness. Okay, another parcel that arrived today that I was not expecting but couldn't be more excited about. Oh, ignore the cat. I had a box of peanut butter arrived from Manny Life. spoke about these recently. It's my favourite peanut butter ever. They have sent me a parcel with a limited edition small batch of peanut butter, which is mince pie. It's mince peanut butter. We have to try this. We have to try this now. Luckily, this is a really big coincidence. I bought some crumpets yesterday. Can't remember last time I had a crumpet, but I thought we'd toast one up and try this out now. It could be really weird. It could be really life-changing. And I might need to stock up. That is luminous yellow. Okay, it has bits of minced meat in it. I definitely want to get some of the fruit on here. Bits of fruit, little bits of fruit. Let's give this a try. I'm going to get a bit of the raisin first. Whoa. Mmm. I can't believe this hasn't been done already. That is sublime. That is such a good snack. This has in it 73.7% peanuts, followed by mincemeat, which is sultanas, currants, raisins, brown sugar, apples, white rum, mixed peel, which is orange peel, lemon peel, and then some rapeseed oil, sunflower oil. That is why I love Manulife, because it's just like simple ingredients. Absolutely love that.
What's going on today?
My flies are open.
What do you think it is?
Tiramisu lint balls. Tiramisu lint. Chocolate bar. No, it's too thick for that.
Well, why don't you have a look?
Well, wait. I think you went to M&S. I don't know.
Well, look at it. You're right.
Oh my God. Where'd you get that from?
Italy.
You went to Italy? That's why it took so long to get home today.
No, I went on the way to the pub.
Oh. Oh my goodness. Gracious me. That sounds great. Let's ignore the spot on my chin and focus on what I'm wearing today. I've got a really nice day of events. I'm going to a Rails press show for spring summer 25. Oh my God, time is going so quick. And then I'm going for lunch at a restaurant called iBay. I want to say it's called iBay. I think that's how you pronounce it. And it's to celebrate the launch of an Australian wine brand in Sainsbury's, which is exciting. Oh God, what is wrong with my hair? I'm having one of those days where I just don't like my face. It looks old and decrepit, but here's what I'm wearing. I think it's my hair. I really just need to book in for a fringe trim. And maybe a cut because it's so long right now. So I'm wearing this structured t-shirt that I wore last week on my date night. I really like it. I think it's really smart. So I plan to take the blazer off when I get to the events. And then I've just got on my kind of flared black jeans and these brown loafers that I got a while ago from Primark but haven't worn yet because I got them in a size 5 and I'm a size 4, but I've just put some insoles in and they don't feel too bad. So I'm going to brave new shoes today, even though I've never worn these ones out before. Denim jacket with floors, and then also little shorts to match. You and jeans as well. I also love this two-piece cord. So pretty. I finished my event slightly early, so I've come for a coffee at Monmouth in Covent Garden. I'm sitting outside, and I feel like a Parisian right now. The clothes in Rails were so nice. I'm really excited for spring and summer now, even though it hasn't even been Christmas yet. Don't mind us, we're just making some lunch. I'm just feeling so rubbish about my skin. It makes me not want to vlog. So if I seem a bit down. That's why. It's just only because I'm so self-conscious and embarrassed. What?
Can I put the
back on? Yeah. I'm just so angry at myself for eating so much ice cream. It's all my own fault. And I'm literally about to have more chocolate now because I've just been sent the most amazing box from Nescafe. I think I actually showed these. Did I show them? I definitely like took a picture of them in a vlog when I went to B&M a couple of weeks ago. That Nescafe have partnered with Nestle to bring out these amazing limited edition. I think they're limited edition. I hope they're not. Chocolate inspired mochas. So we've got the Quality Street Green Triangle Mocha, which is hazelnut flavoured. Oh my god, I was literally just about to make one of those, but I feel like a fancy mint. So I'm going to try. Me and Gio about to have a glass of the Aero. And then they've also got Golden Honeycomb, which just sounds insane. So yeah, I'm going to make us some of these, and I'm also making myself a crumpet with some mince pie peanut butter, which is not the healthiest lunch, but gonna be really freaking delicious. I might put a bit of collagen powder in mine as well, actually. Really gobbly. This evening we are going on a date to watch some basketball. We're gonna go and watch the London Lions, which is London's like home basketball team. We've seen them once before and it was so fun, and today Jeff bought us tickets to be courtside, so we're gonna be like on the court. Are we like on the court?
Courtside. Pretty much.
I'm nervous. I am wearing white mango wide leg jeans. I've got a very, very old V-neck top on with my Edge of Ember necklace, and I'm wearing a coat that was very kindly gifted to me at the Rails event yesterday. I absolutely love it. It's like faux leather cropped and like so soft. It has this like faux fur on the inside, and I was a bit worried choosing this out because I thought it has potential to make me look quite out of proportion because it's quite bulky, but actually I think because it's cropped it does, like, the proportions work. So I'm very excited to have this new winter coat in my wardrobe. I can't stop rubbing the fur, it's so nice. Here we go. And I'm gonna take my Coach handbag. This one here.
We're at the basketball game. Look at our seats.
Morning, and we are about to decorate. We're about to sort our stairs out. So far we've cleaned them, we've cleaned the stairs and the banisters, and we've taken these rods off that were kind of, I don't even know what you'd call them, carpet runner rods or something. So this is what we're dealing with, and we're going to paint this white and this, yeah, and this needs doing as well. And then we're gonna paint this black. And we've got some new light shades up there, so it's gonna look great once the new carpets go in, which are going in next week.
Yeah, and the wall probably needs a little bit of touch up if we've got any paint left, I'm not sure. So yeah, a little bit of home improvements today.
It is a very exciting Sunday night, guys, because we went to M&S yesterday and we got picky bits for dinner for the next 2 days. So for the next 2 days, we are eating picky bits from M&S, which is so exciting. We're heating up 2 steamed bao buns. This is a polar bear. And this is a penguin. He's very smart. And they're filmed, they're filled with hoisin and vegetables, I think. So those just go in the microwave. And then what else we've got is, we've got some mini pies. What flavours? We've got, six chicken leek and six beef and gravy. So we've got two of those each to try. And then we've also got some mini Yorkshire puddings, which is just the best thing about Christmas. There you go. So we've got two pies each, one of each flavour. And then we've got some picky, snacky little Yorkshire puddings filled with, what are they filled with? Beef and horseradish.
Yeah.
Oh, it kind of looks like a mushroom pate or something. We're also eating some dip and crackers. What are they filled
with? Slow-cooked pulled beef with rich red wine and porcini mushroom jus.
Didn't I say
garlic
that?
Garlic and herb crumb.
Didn't I say that it looked like mushroom?
Garlic and herb crumb. Like.
So yeah, that's what we're eating for dinner tonight. I'm not in. You're really excited about those turmeric cauliflower florets, yeah. But I'm not so much.
Do you not want any?
I'll have one. We've also just got the nicest, like, sweet snacky bits from M&S. So I'll show you those as well. Just, I feel like M&S food at the moment, like this year, is just elevated to a great standard, and I'm very excited about it. I thought I'd vlog this content. I hope you guys enjoy it too. Although I do realise I get much more excited about food than most or your average person. We've also got these dark chocolate chili tortilla crisps. So on one side they've got dark chocolate and the other side they've got like chili Doritos. So we're going to try these now.
I'm a bit scared of this.
Ready? I'm not getting much chili. But we do know chili and chocolate does go together, doesn't it?
A little bit of heat coming through. I'm not sure about that.
I've seen people talking about these, saying they're amazing. I actually don't rate them as much as everyone says. I feel like they're a better savoury and sweet chocolate and crisp combos out there, like Smash, which are the best things ever. This is my dinner tonight. We were just talking about how great being an adult is. It's like one of the few joys you get as an adult, isn't it? Being able to have whatever you want for dinner. Like, along with all the bill paying and all the money worries.
I mean, I'll eat my penguin.
Go on then. You do get to choose to eat stuff like this for dinner. Might be very hot inside. Mmm.
Mmm.
Mmm. It's also a very exciting day, guys, because we went to Blue Water today to meet up with my family. We went for lunch, and there's a Lindt store in Blue Water, and I finally got my hands on the tiramisu Lindt balls. So we're going to try one now. How exciting! I've been, honestly, since I heard that they were doing these in the UK. I was so excited. If you ever go to Paris or Zurich, it was Paris we found that bar in, wasn't it?
Bar?
That tiramisu Lindt bar. Was it Paris we found that in? I'm pretty
sure. Yeah, I think it was.
Yeah.
If
you guys go to Paris, you have to go to the Lindt store. I think it's near like one of the massive museums or like an or opera hall. I can't quite remember. They do tiramisu chocolate bars in there, like an actual big chocolate bar, and it's the best chocolate ever, the tiramisu Lindt bar. They, for some reason, they don't do it in the UK. It's so weird. So I am happy that they've bought this, the balls out. But I am hoping as well that that means maybe soon they'll bring the bars into the UK, because who else has heard that they're opening a Lindt store in Piccadilly Circus, like near the M&M World store. They're bringing in like a massive Lindt store, which is so exciting. So yeah, I'm hoping with the launch of that they will also bring out the tiramisu Lindt balls, but we're gonna try them now. I'm quite full. Oh, M&S reviews, I thought those mini pies might have been my favorite.
They were very good.
The chicken and the beef was there, they were great. The bao buns I wouldn't buy again, they were a bit of a disappointment. The mini Yorkies were great. Very mushroomy. Whoa! Here you go.
Thanks, man.
We've got to eat this. Oh, milk chocolate. I reckon it'll be white inside. Do we know that? No.
Sounds very, like, very coffee-like.
Coffee, yeah, very coffee. But very sweet as well. Oh. Oh, not white inside. What do you think about that? It's got bits in it.
Too heavy on the coffee. Not enough cream.
It is like a coffee revel. Much sweeter.
It's better than that bar we got from Eataly.
Yeah, it is better than the Eataly tiramisu bar. I like this. Even though I love tiramisu, I actually think the Bailey's Irish Cream Lint Balls might be better. I really enjoyed those.
I'd probably just go plain old red.
You can't beat a normal one.
They've gone too big on the coffee on that one. Could have had some, like, cream in there.
It's got wafer pieces in it. And a smooth melting mascarpone and coffee filling. I like it.
Wouldn't say no to them. Mm-mm. But also...
a bit of a disappointment.
Too coffee. But it is a coffee dessert, to be fair.
It is.